Angel Tips 1-4, 2015, A John Powell Tale, Part 9 of 27. The western horizon holds a barely visible band of purple, but the moon to the east dominates Red Rock Canyon's 5:30 celestial sphere. Jody's sunroof is open, the heater is blasting, and the enchanting loveliness of the park's scenic loop is only challenged by my new friend's beauty. I am entranced by the glory of being with her as we circle the park, my left hand resting beneath Jody's right thigh as we meander through the desert magnificence along with Angel and Joe. So, I tossed to the back seat. Good ride. Oh, it was great, Angel declares. I've never ridden an electric bike before. They were a blast. Throttle? I asked. Nope, Joe said. That's part of the cool. You have to pedal. The motor just helps. They'll go 28 miles an hour. Zoom, zoom. Don't you feel like that's cheating? Jody asked. Cheating on what? Fun? Hell no, Joe said with a laugh. Just flatten things out, that's all. You select how much oomph it gives. Four levos and turbo feels like you could pull a wheelie. Can't, of course. Suckers are heavy. But with the motor, it's just cruise as hard as you want and no need to suffer. I might buy one when I get back home. Sure would make cruising up and down Filbert Street a possibility. Filbert Street? Jody asked. Steepest street in San Francisco, Angel declares. Huh, I say before asking. Gee, what would Mom and Dad say? Mischievous grin softening my next line. We were taught that suffering is good for the soul. Yeah, Joe drawled. I don't know about you, but I gave up being Catholic when Paul VI passed away. You can keep your self-denial and mortification. Really? I asked. Seem to recall a mass when you and Janann got married. Pretty nominal even way back then. Definitely stopped when she passed. You still go to mass? He asked, incredulous. Almost never, I conceded quietly. Probably more for Max's sake than anything else. He enjoys it, so when he's around, I'll go with him. I say those old prayers, though. Helps lull me to sleep when my brain won't quit. Or when the demons are knocking? Joe asks, his hand on my shoulder. It gets better, bro, he adds softly. I know, I choke out. Sorry, I add, looking back at Angel and smiling and squeezing Jody's right knee. I know it does. Future's full of hope. What about you, Angel? Brought up Catholic? Me? A little girl from the Philippines? Why would you think that? She asks with a laugh. Yes, I think the term is cultural Catholic, but I'm one of those spiritual, not religious millennials you hear so much about. What about you, Jody? Are we unanimous? You grew up Catholic? Nope, I grew up a Hoosier. Pretty sure I'm a heathen. About the only time I go to church is for weddings or funerals. Well, let's hope we don't have any of the latter in the foreseeable future. I've had enough, I say quietly. Coming up on 2 years, I say to Joe. For Dad? Yep, next month. He was good people. As was Mom. They both were. And Eileen, he says again, squeezing my shoulder. And Janann, I reply quietly. The only noise that breaks the following quiet is the car's heater and the rush of wind through the sunroof until a coyote breaks the deafening silence. And on that note, Joe declares, maybe we should change the subject, as he howls at the full moon that peeks through a corner of Jody's sunroof. Yep, Joe said whimsically, think I'm going to buy me one of those Trek XM700s. That was fun. Might come in handy for you to come visit me downtown, Angel says. I guess it would at that, Joe responds, not a trace of inflection indicating that he has any plans to do so.